Edward Byrd, a North Dakota nurse from World War I, had said, "For laying down their lives in France and worldwide, so our country might live." And I specifically would like to give a special thank you to my family, who has had a long history of serving in North Dakota. Two of my great-great uncles on my mother's side, Gustav Hinz and Ferdinand Martel, gave the ultimate price of life in World War II. And their names are enshrined on the All Veterans Centennial Memorial on the Capitol ground. My great uncle Raymond Kauk fought in World War II as well, and he even lied about his age to serve, and ended up spending his 18th birthday as a POW in Germany. Along with my great uncle Raymond Kauk, five of his siblings, including my grandfather, whose flag we use today, signed up to fight for our country in our country's wars. Both of my mom's brothers, Dennis and James, served in times of peace. Dennis, who died in 2006, not from serving his country, but from his time in service. He signed up for the Army in 1981, and at the age of 45, in 1998, he became a symbol of bravery and sacrifice in our family. When he was ran over by an Army tank in a Hummer during a training exercise in California, the tank smashed him 12 inches into the ground, and he survived it while suffering a heart attack. And it is that heart attack that he had while 12 inches in the ground that led to his death in 2006. He was driving in a school zone, and just like the Army had taught him, he pulled over and became a hero, protecting the town that we live in and our country. And my Uncle James, who never had any physical injuries in the war, like before him, he made a personal sacrifice as well. He signed up and joined the Navy a month before his first son was born, and I'm forever grateful for that. I want to say a special thank you to my family members from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for serving. Thank you for protecting our country, and thank you for protecting my future, even though I wasn't even a thought yet. But most of all, thank you. Again, I would like to thank everyone here, every past soldier and every future soldier, for paying the prices of our country freedom, which is our country's freedom. And to all the in the audience who have served or who have family members who have served, thank you for those sacrifices. Thank you for protecting our futures, and I hope we make you proud of them. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.